Representative Starla, I want to officially thank you for hosting us here in Lancaster County. It's a beautiful site we're in, a beautiful place. I want to thank you for having us today.
Thanks. Well, thanks for coming here. Sure. You know, it's a great facility we have here, the Hotel and Convention Center in Lancaster, and something we're proud of, and you know, part of some of the economic development that's been going on, not only here in Lancaster, but around the state.
Sure. Well, in addition to representing about 60,000 constituents in Lancaster County, you also hold the hat of being the House Majority Policy Committee Chairman. And through that, you really help shape what bills see a lot of legislative attention. You get almost a bird's eye view from testimony, from public hearings, from experts, and public opinion on different bills. So throughout the past 2 years, that you've been the chairman of this committee, and we have here that you've held almost 60 hearings across the state and almost in every corner of the state. So tell us why you go basically from Erie to Pittsburgh to Philadelphia and everywhere in between.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think it's important for several reasons. One, we get to gather a lot of information from around the state and get to understand how people around the state feel differently about different views on some of the issues. But it also allows us then, as we gather information, to then help pass that information on to different areas and let people know, you know, in Erie what people in Philadelphia are thinking about, and people in Scranton let them know what people in Pittsburgh are thinking, in some cases about the same issue, and they may have differing views on those.
Sure. Is it because we have really urban areas on each corner, and then you have rural and suburban mixed right in there? Is it because Pennsylvania is such a diverse state that there's so many different issues that affect different parts?
Well, I think so. And, you know, whether it's rural, suburban, or urban, there's also the whole issue that we talked a lot about was Marcellus Shale this time. There's an area that's dramatically affected by the Marcellus Shale play. There's another area that really is sort of, you know, affected way downstream if the water gets polluted.
Sure.
And things like that. And in terms of transportation, there's a whole lot of issues also that we had talked about that are diverse. You know, whether you're doing mass transit in some of the more urbanized areas or whether you're looking at gravel roads in some parts of the state.
Sure. Now, we have, as I said here, almost 60 hearings in the last 2 years, but doesn't necessarily mean 60 different topics, does it? Were there some that you revisited and know what constituted something as being important to get a second hearing on it, or a different part of the state a hearing on it?
Yeah. Well, there were a couple issues in particular that we focused on. We actually did joint hearings with the Republican Policy Committee and the Democratic Policy Committee and both sides of the aisle from the transportation committees, and went around the state and did transportation hearings to look at that issue, because it is an immense issue in the state of Pennsylvania and has a whole lot of aspects to it. So we thought that that was necessary, and it's really a nonpartisan issue that we worked on there. On the Marcellus Shale issue, we also held quite a number of hearings on that, and again, there's the environmental issues, there's the economic development issues, there's the whole issue of taxing the Marcellus Shale and getting our fair share for that, because we're the only state in the nation that has natural gas deposits that doesn't tax it at this point in time. So there were a lot of different aspects we got. We heard from landowners, we heard from drilling companies, we heard from environmentalists, and to gather that kind of information, it's really tough to do it in one location in one day. We're still learning. Every time we hold one of those hearings, I think we learn something new.
So then what happens after that? Do some of that public input, that expert testimony, does it get shaped into a bill? Does it come in the form of an amendment to the bill? Does it help really shape an end product?
Yeah, well, it comes in a lot of ways. There are some that actually took the form of pieces of legislation themselves. And we actually passed, I think it was about 65 bills into law this year. There's another 150 plus that we sent to the Senate that the Senate didn't act on. But all that comes as a result of that input and being able to tweak that legislation, make it a little better, fine-tune it, if you will. And a lot of that occurs from the information we gather out at policy hearings.
Sure. Well, Representative Starla, you mentioned Marcellus Shale and transportation throughout. If you had to do a top three of important issues to the committee, I would assume those two would fit in there somewhere. But what do you think would be your third?
Well, I'd probably have to say jobs and economic development. Given the current economic climate, that's something that's important to all of Pennsylvania. And we dealt with some issues in terms of worker classification and how we go about stimulating jobs and growth in the state of Pennsylvania. There's still some more work to be done on that, though, also. And that's one of those issues that is on our high priority list.
And finally, how would you gauge the committee's success this season? How well do you think they helped shape the legislative agenda this past 2 years?
Yeah. Well, I'll give our committee mixed grades. We were able to get a whole lot of issues brought to light. There were a couple that we wanted to push over the end line that we didn't. The Marcellus Shale tax is still out there. That's something that I think is going to have to be dealt with. The notion that you can just ignore $1 billion in revenue that will otherwise come out of the citizens' pockets just doesn't make sense. The other one is the transportation issue. We've got a looming crisis with bridges and roads that need repaired in this state. And so I think we're going to have to push a little more on that. But we certainly set the groundwork for it. We've got enough information now that we're well armed and ready to go fight that fight.
Okay, Representative Sterla, unfortunately, that's all the time we have. But once again, I want to thank you for hosting us in beautiful Lancaster County. It's been a pleasure.
All right. Thanks for being here.